Hello there. Have you ever wondered why there were no land disputes between the naturally blessed resource country Ghana, then the Gold Coast, and the British, its colonial master, as compared to some Eastern and Southern African countries? All thanks to this man, John Mensah Sarbah, who fought the land reforms the British were trying to introduce in the late part of the 18th century in the Gold Coast. John Mensah Sarbah was born at Cape Coast in 1864, eldest son to a merchant, John Sarbah, and his wife, Sarah. He was educated at Cape Coast Wesleyan School and at Taunton School, Devon, in England. In 1884, he entered Lincoln's Inn in England to study law and qualified as a barrister in 1887, being the first African from the Gold Coast to gain this qualification. He built a lucrative practice on his return home and also took over his father's business in 1892 after his demise. His interest in politics, which he had shown during his study days in England, led him to take more active role in politics. Although he accepted the basic assumption of the British imperial regime and felt that some of the evils of the crown colony system should be checked, he therefore helped J.P. Brown, J.W. de Graaf Johnson, and others to form the Aborigines' Rights Protection Society, ARPS, to watch over the interests of the African population. The ARPS opposed the Land Bill of 1897, which threatened the traditional system of land tenure, and sent Sarbah to argue against its passage in the Legislative Council. When the governor, Sir William Maxwell, who was the governor from 1895 to 1897, refused to withdraw the bill, Sarbah advised the ARPS to send a delegation to England to petition against its passage. The delegation, which Sarbah refused out of modesty to lead, went to England in 1898 and made it clear to the appropriate authorities that in the Gold Coast, land belongs to the dead, the living, and the unborn, and succeeded in getting the land bill disallowed. This achievement saved the Gold Coast from the evils of the alienation of African lands as occurred in the British colony of Kenya. Sarbah returned the money given to him by the ARPS because he felt it was an honor to serve his country. The ARPS later used the money to establish a press.
Sarbah was interested in promoting secondary education because he felt it was the best way to enable Africans to gain the respect of the civilized world. His first act in this direction was to found a Dutton scholarship at Taunton School in memory of his younger brother, Joseph Dutton Sarbah, who had died there in 1892. When, for financial reasons, the Wesleyan mission closed down the Cape Coast Wesleyan School, he and some other nationalists revived it, financed it, and renamed it the Collegiate School. Upon returning from Europe in 1903, together with William Edward Sam, promoted an enterprise called the Franti Public Schools Limited.
This led to the foundation of Infant Scheme School in 1904 and later merged with the Collegiate School in 1906 and retained the name Infant Scheme School. Sarbah is said to have given the school the motto Dream Shekan, meaning think and look ahead, as well as its emblem. The school to date has produced some of the country's best known public figures in all walks of life. Men such as Alex Kwesi Nsaki, former president of the UN General Assembly, Dr. Kofi Abrefa Buzia, president of the Second Republic, Kofi Annan, former general secretary of the UN. He also helped to establish the Franti National Education Fund, which aimed at improving educational facilities in the country and also awarded scholarship. He single-handedly founded a scholarship at Infant Scheme School and helped pay the salaries of staff when the school encountered financial difficulties. In 1963, over 50 years of his death, the University of Ghana named the Mensah Sarbah Hall after him for his service to education. Sarbah House at Infant Scheme is also named after him. As a legislator, Sarbah was interested in law reforms and tried his best to prevent the passage of laws inimical to the interests of his countrymen. He proposed that in perjury, the falsehood with which the witness could be charged should concern a matter material raised in the judicial proceedings. His suggestion was adopted in 1951. As a lawyer, he was interested in spreading knowledge of Fanti laws and of the Fanti constitution. He therefore published two books, the Fanti customary laws in 1897 and Fanti national constitution in 1906. He was married to Marianne Wood of Accra in 1904 and they had three children. He died in 1910 without making any provision in his will for the education of his children, probably because he believed that the Akan family system would cater for them. Thank you for staying with me till now. I would like to use this opportunity to plead with you to subscribe, like, share, and comment because there are more interesting content to share with you, lovely viewers.